I recently participated in my first ever Ludum Dare game jam, and I had tons of fun. So let me take you through my entry, Submarine Bean. Hey everyone, I'm Icoso, and I just submitted my entry into the 48th Ludum Dare game jam. Like, I just hit publish 5 minutes ago. We don't mess around here. There is the jam, which goes for 72 hours, but I participated in the compo, which is 48 hours, and done completely solo. I don't have too much else to say about it, so let's just jump right into it. The game jam started at 10:30 a.m. for me, which I think was just about the best timing you could get. Waking up on Saturday morning, I drank some iced coffee, it was so good, and then sat at my laptop for 4 hours waiting for the game jam to start. But eventually the timer clicked down, past zero for some reason, and the theme was announced, deeper and deeper. Now, if I were a normal indie game developer YouTuber, I'd be having a whiteboard drawing my ideas down. But I am no normal indie game dev YouTuber. My first idea was sort of Minecraft, digging deeper and deeper down until you die in lava, but I thought it was a bit too generic and straightforward. But I still like the idea of going deeper into the earth. So I made it underwater. Oh yeah, I'm so cool. Basically, you're gonna be a submarine, dodging bombs underwater. Great stuff, I know. I created my Unity project, and the first thing I did was draw a submarine. I'm not really an artist, but I think it turned out okay, but this is where the name Submarine Bean came from, because it looks like a bean. To make sure that other people could recognize what it was, I conducted the DAD test. It stands for DAD, a looks at drawing. Just let me show you.
What does that look like to you?
A fish.
So with my fish, apparently, I brought it over into Unity and set up some basic player movement. I did my best to make it feel quite natural since, you know, you're underwater. Next, I made some tiles for the ground, and, yeah, not the best, like, at all, and I did redraw them later. Then we had some family stuff on, some of my cousins came over and screamed so loudly playing Super Smash Bros, but yeah, that was about it for the night. In my dreams, Bob Ross came to me. He enlightened me with the knowledge of my game. He said, "Your game looks bad, and also please subscribe." So, with this wise information, I woke up on Sunday morning and began redoing the artwork for my game. Also, I added some seaweed and rocks and vines and stuff like that. I also drew some adorable, cute little fishies to add some more life into the scene. So, with all of these pieces and with a little help from Unity's particle system, this is what the game looked like now. I also used maths for the first time, like ever. As this submarine got lower down, I wanted everything to become a little darker. I created this logarithmic equation to do so, and it worked great. I can't believe I actually used something I learned from school. Now, I had about 24 hours left to make the game. I jumped into making the first level. The red things on screen are the bombs which you don't want to hit, but instead reach the magical glowing portal at the bottom of the screen. It's a pretty simple idea and mechanic, I agree, but I really had to keep everything in scope to get it done on time. I moved on to making a main menu and level select screen. These always take a while to create, so it was good to get them out of the way, and this is how they turned out. Again, quite simple, but it worked. Then I spent some time creating the next handful of levels before jumping into some music production. I use FL Studio, and the first thing I did was create some chords with a piano sound. Then I added some guitar, drums, and bass. Then I put everything together and added a few extra details. If you want to hear the full song, I'll be doing a playthrough of the game at the end of the video, and the song will be on my second channel soon if it's not there already. The rest of the night, I mainly worked on levels and also created these colourful choral arrangements to add some more vibrance into the scene. I stopped working for the night with about 12 hours left. I created 10 levels, and I wish I was able to make some more, but I had to keep everything within the time frame. As I slept that night, Bob Ross came to me once again. All he had to say was crab. I woke up and I drew a crab. It looks like a footy with arms and legs, and his name is Mr. Kaklakers. There is one of him in each level, so go catch them all, I don't know. I spent the rest of the morning cleaning things up, squishing any bugs I could find, and creating the pages for submission. I had an absolute blast with this game jam, and as I said, I will now run a playthrough of the game. Thanks so much for watching, everyone, and a massive thank you to my awesome patrons, Fartfish and Luat Games. See ya. Hey everyone, thanks so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe and do all of the cool things. See ya.